Last week, teachers from schools registered by the Education Ministry for the selection exercise of schools that are purely under universal secondary education and government-aided schools that do not have USE were in Kampala to witness the selection exercise. The exercise included giving of lists containing the names of students on which the selection committee based the number of students admitted to schools and the numbers that should be distributed to other schools based on the cutoff points. After this, UPC has expressed concern over the selection exercise, saying that the result causes a national challenge.
This issue was planned early enough. If you admit people, at least know. Right now, the policy is that at least in every parish there is a primary school with one secondary school in the entire sub-county. Meaning this sub-county, all these secondary schools in the entire sub-county cannot be able to absorb the primary levers about the P7 candidates from over 10 school primary schools, if we can put at that scale, to one secondary school. So this one should be an urgent call to the Minister of Education, to the government, for timely planning. And this is what we are doing as UPC. We note these concerns as very much worrying.
The party has thus advised the government to reinstate the suspended partnership program with private schools so that the unadmitted students can be wholly absorbed as a matter of urgency.
We are increasingly having these students being left out. So the only way is to renew partnership. Look at that kind of partnership or collaboration, how it was working. We should not just look at these people or students being wasted like that.
UPC eulogized a fallen Namibian president, Dr. Hage Geingob, who died on Sunday, 4th February, praising him for being active in the decolonization and independence struggle of Namibia, whose country was under the mandate of the apartheid South Africa. The party saluted Namibia for deepening democracy, governance, constitutionalism and development, and asked Uganda as a country to emulate the same. Derek Asaba, reporting for the news.